In this video, we'll cover the difference between the final URL, destination URL, display URL, and display path in Google Ads. All of these terms relate to the URLs we use with our ads. Let's head to Google Ads to take a look. I've already logged into my demo account, so let's navigate to Campaigns and then Ads. This is where you can see all of the search and display ads in your account. The first ad is for a search campaign. Let's click the pencil icon to edit this ad. At the top, we can see the final URL. This is the landing page on your website that people will be taken to when they click on your ad. The final URL was previously called the destination URL. So just remember that the final URL and destination URL mean the same thing. When you create an ad, you should use a final URL that relates to the targeting you are using and the ad copy you write for the ad. For a search campaign, this means the final URL should relate to the keywords you are targeting and the headlines and descriptions you are going to show to people as they are searching. On the right, we can see a preview of how our ad might appear. Let's click pause, so we're just looking at one example. So the final URL is where people will land on our website when they click our ad. Next is the display URL. This is the URL that is shown to people when they see our ad. Looking at the preview, this is the small URL shown under the name of our company or website. Looking at the preview, the display URL is www.lovesdata.com/. As you can see, the final URL and display URL don't need to be exactly the same, especially because you will want to use a specific link for the final URL and avoid sending people to your homepage. The next option is to use a display path. This lets you include a folder structure in the display URL. Since we're editing a responsive search ad, we can see the option to include two folders, each with up to 15 characters, just below the final URL. These are optional, but you can use them to provide additional context as people are searching and see your ad. People are more likely to read your headline and description before looking at the display URL and display path. But if you can make the display path relevant to keywords and ad copy, it's a good idea. You can also test the display path using an experiment. Since my ad is sending people to one of my blog posts, we could enter blog in the display path. We can see the preview updates, and now our display URL includes /blog. This helps people understand where they will land on the website if they click on the ad. Now I want to show you the URL options available if you are managing display and performance max campaigns. To do this, let's close this ad. We're still looking at all of the ads in my demo account, so let's scroll down. And here we can see a display ad. Let's click the edit icon for this ad. Here we can see we're only given the option to use a final URL with our display ad. This means we don't have the option to control the display URL for ads that are shown on the display network. Okay, let's close this ad. And let's navigate to a Performance Max campaign. And let's select Asset Groups. Asset groups contain all of the images, headlines, descriptions, and other elements used to create ads that are shown for Performance Max campaigns. Let's edit this asset group to take a look. Like the other ads we've looked at, we can see the final URL at the top. We can select this to edit it. Again, this is the landing page people will be taken to when they click our ad. Now let's scroll down. And let's select more options at the bottom. We can then select display path like we saw with our responsive search ad. And we can even choose to use a different final URL for people using mobile devices. So that's the difference between the final URL, display URL, and display path in Google Ads. Remember that you should always use the final URL to send people to the most relevant page on your website for the particular keywords or other targeting you are using in your campaign. To learn even more about Google Ads, please take a moment to subscribe to this channel and check out the extra resources in the description. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.